everybody. Stephen Brody Stevens here with Esther. It is Brode and Esther, episode 12. 11?
11.
Episode 11. My name is Stephen Brody Stevens. We're here with Red Man. This is Death Squad Studios here. We're in Pasadena live. I'm not going to play to the camera much. I'm just going to look down and I'm going to focus on the podcast. Good. I'm not going to focus on the cameras. So
why? Why don't you want to focus on the cameras?
Because I can only do one thing right now. And if the cameras are here, I'm just going to focus on the podcast.
New strategy. Let's see how it goes.
Right. Well, I have to. Because I, you know what, I'm going to be honest, and that you not want me to be honest.
No, you can be honest. Tell us what.
This is Esther, everybody. Give Esther a nice hand. You know, Esther's very
some
funny.
Horses in the house.
Horses?
Horses.
Where? Pikachu.
Ew. Esther and Brian, you're going to probably have to carry the show tonight.
No.
This is a big opportunity for you.
What happened, Brody? Talk to us.
I think I smoked a little pot, and I'm not supposed to, and you know what? I'll be honest. I feel paranoid right now, and I'm doing, this is a test. This is, you know, to show me, it's on record now, to understand that I should not at least perform high, and I've been very good with that, and you know what? I disrespected the podcast by smoking pot before, and I want to apologize. It's not professional, but I have to be honest with you. I'm going to be honest about a lot of things, and then I'll be able to set myself free.
Can I tell you something, Brody?
Yes.
This is such an overwhelmingly accepted share. I'm so excited that you... Thank you for sharing this. Today, I did something bad, too. That I wasn't supposed to do.
What was that?
I was in the valley today. And
so was I.
Oh. And I was going to go work out in the valley. And I went to Chipotle instead. And I know you think, oh, that's not that big of a deal. But I usually get just a burrito bowl at Chipotle. And today, for the first time in probably 10 years, I had a burrito and I ate the whole thing, and then I got ice cream right afterwards, and I feel
and then ice cream, like a Chipotle burrito is humongous. How did you do that and then get ice cream?
Look, Brian, that's a negative response, and it makes
were me, you celebrating?
No, I wasn't celebrating. I felt bad about myself. And
why did you feel bad? Well, you feel bad that you had Chipotle and ice cream.
Yeah, I think I have post-audition stress disorder. And after my audition, I felt like I had a traumatic, stressful experience. And I went to Chipotle in the valley, and I ate a whole burrito. And then I called my mom to tell her about it, and she made me feel worse.
Were you more stressed out by the audition or stressed out that you ate the burrito?
That I ate the burrito.
That takes precedent over the audition.
Yes, it does. Yes, sir.
Can I ask you about the audition as I focus on the podcast?
Yes.
Was it for like a cool show?
No, just a standard little thing. It wasn't a big deal, but I get it, when I have to wait a long time, it reminds you of being a kid and waiting for the doctors, and then I get an attitude and I get stressed out. And I get, like, yeah, I have an attitude problem.
Really?
Yeah.
What were you stressed out about?
Well, it threw off my day.
The burrito or the audition?
Everything.
Everything?
Yeah.
You didn't have a good experience auditioning?
Afterwards, I did, but it still made me stressed out, all the waiting.
Did you have sex after the audition?
No, I didn't.
Brian.
Unless you consider eating a Chipotle burrito by yourself sex. No, I did not have sex. Some may consider that sex. In fact, it was good, okay?
You got to reward yourself once in a while.
That's true, and that would be fair if I didn't also have a grilled ham and cheese sandwich on Saturday night at a nice restaurant.
Saturday night?
Yeah.
It's Monday. You had Sunday to recover.
Yeah, you've already pooped that out.
Brian, let's keep it clean. Come on, man.
Yeah, Brian, that's disgusting.
Disgusting.
Ew.
You know, we should say, I feel like watching the news, I don't want to be a downer, but I feel like we need to get to it.
Yeah.
This Hurricane Sandy is scaring me.
Me too.
I mean, it seems like to be one of those developing stories, like a natural disaster. And there's going to be a lot. There already is a lot of damage.
My friend Sandy, not the hurricane, but the comedian, is in New York. And he's...
Don Barris went to New York either today or last night to do Kimmel, and they can't do it. They had to cancel the show. And then I said that you should probably just do it in the hotel room. And I guess they were about to do that, you know, like just have like a very low-key show, but at the last minute they decided not to. But David Letterman did it to a no-studio audience tonight.
New Yorkers, East Coasters, they're tough. They deal with this kind of, I mean, not this specifically, but they deal with a lot of stuff. If L.A. had rain like that or a hurricane, we can handle earthquakes, I mean, I think.
Yeah, we're used to it.
We're like mentally prepared for an earthquake.
Right. Well, I shouldn't say we, but the people from here are used to small earthquakes. Right.
Did you see any of the photos that have been going around, you
No.
know, or anything like that? There's one that George Takei, I don't know if you guys know him from Star Trek,
Yeah.
Star Trek and stuff like that. He posted some crazy photos of a shark that was just swimming around.
Oh, my God.
And,
that's amazing.
Oh, my God. I'm getting so freaked out looking at that.
In New Jersey, I guess that is.
A shark.
Oh, my God. I can't look at it.
And look at this, Manhattan. It's just
where? What neighborhood?
It's by the pizza pie place. Boo! I don't know.
No one told me that this was happening. I don't. What, we should get like iPhone updates.
Godzilla coming by the.
That's fake.
Is it? Is that fake, Brian?
No. But look at this. Like a house on a pier.
I have a fear of water, and this is freaking me out.
I used to live in a neighborhood that was flooded, and it was just kind of like that. We had like some weird break, like water main break or something like that, and flooded the whole neighborhood. My cat ran away and died. And when I was a kid, but it was really cool because we could swim down the streets, and it was really neat swimming down your neighborhood street.
You actually swam?
Yeah, because we were kids, so we like had rafts. We were like, you know, we were like, it was the best thing in the whole entire world, but.
Was that in Ohio?
Was it really the best thing in the whole entire world? What about having sex with hot girls?
Well, when
is
you're
that better?
When you're 12, I think it was better than that, probably. Okay. But it was...
good question, Esther.
Thank you.
Now, looking back at it, like, I wouldn't do it in New York, because that probably is the grossest water in the world. It's just, like, poop water and, you know, drug water.
Yeah,
and,
I'm sure the Ohio water is...
Well, neighborhood versus New York City, I'm sure is better, right?
New York City, that water, if you're going to do the swim... routine. New York water is probably dirtier. Yes.
Brody weighing in on the swim routine.
Steve Renazzisi just texted me.
What did he say?
From the league. Storm got me delayed going east. Want to hike / podcast tomorrow?
Invite him over now.
I have a podcast schedule. Well, I probably could. Have Steve come on the show. Steve Renazzisi would be a good podcast guest.
Mm-hmm.
That would be a good get.
Yeah.
So I'm going to have to get back to him on that.
It's funny.
Esther, so go ahead, Brian. You were talking about something.
I'm scared, you guys.
What are you scared about, Esther?
I just saw a picture of a shark and approaching a house.
But why are you scared?
It just scares me in general. It could happen to anybody. And also...
Of course. Not anybody.
Did you see the video footage of the Statue of Liberty with just the hand popping out of the water? Like you could just see the hand.
What? Yeah. You're making that up.
He's making that up, but that's
Brian.
Did you ever see Ghostbusters 2 when the Statue of Liberty comes to life and say it, like battles the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man or something?
No, but I saw Planet of the Apes and I don't want to give anything
exactly.
away.
Exactly.
But that scared me.
Yeah, that
and that's why I'm really nice to all animals.
That gave me goosebumps.
Really? I need to see that.
Although the ending was ruined for me by my dad, but anyway. Literally, when we sat down to watch the movies, like, I just want to tell you the whole time. It's, and then you said it. anyway.
I'm more scared of what, like...
I don't want my dad to call.
It reminds me of, like, End of the World shit, like, watching this. And then, like, the other day, there was, like, that earthquake and that almost tsunami'd Hawaii or whatever.
Yeah.
And then that makes you think, you know, like, we're sitting on a time bomb living here. You know, we've talked about that before, like, how stupid it really is that we live in L.A. And if something bad like that happens here, it's going to be fucking mad. It's going to be nuts.
Well, it's not stupid that we live in L.A. I mean, look at the people. We're not dealing with sharks in our backyards right now like all the New Yorkers and New Jerseyers.
They're tougher.
By the way, if you could...
We don't have snow here. We don't have... I mean, well, we have earthquakes. We have, you know... I'm not going to say... No, we have brush fires, but that's a little... It's not in the city. I mean, this is in the city. What else? I mean, I don't think we would get these kind of floods. LA's probably more built to deal with floods. Wouldn't you think?
I don't know. For me, I come from the Midwest perspective. We had tornadoes.
Yeah, that was the worst. Yeah, that was scary.
I had, when I was in Minnesota one summer, there was a big tornado scare and we had to hide in like a cellar.
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Hide in the basement underneath the stairs.
Underneath the stairs.
You just hear tornado warnings and you're like, oh my God, this is it. I'm gonna die.
That's, and I'm just a big scaredy cat and it was really traumatic for me and nobody cared.
I lived in Wichita, Kansas. Well, I didn't live, but I was there for summer of 91 maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I was watching Totally Pauly. He was very popular. I used to love that show.
What's Totally Pauly?
Pauly Shore had a television show on MTV. The Weasel.
Oh, wow.
Hey, buddy. Yeah, did he do that sound?
Yeah, buddy. It's the Weasel.
Something like that.
Oh.
So I watched that. I was in Wichita, Kansas, and they had a tornado shelter, but I don't remember having any tornado warnings. But I did live in Wichita, Kansas, and I know tornado warnings have gone off there, and I did spend time there.
When I was a kid, my dad took me to see Twister, and within the first 3 minutes of the movie, there's like a tornado starting, and there's a little dog that gets left out of the tornado shelter, and I started crying, and we had to leave the theater.
You cried in Twister?
Yeah.
And you had to leave the theater?
Yeah. I've left a lot of movies.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
What's another movie you left?
The Horse Whisperer, because it was too boring.
Oh, okay.
What's the one, the Tim Burton one with, like, the animation? I left that because it was too scary.
The Night Before Christmas? Something like that?
Yeah. Wasn't it Halloween related? Didn't he have a Halloween?
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was with Jack.
Yeah, we had to leave the theater because it was scary.
I'm not that smart in terms of movies. There's so many more people out there who know movies than I would.
Same here.
I can only focus on...
Comedy.
Being the best me, doing comedy. Well, I haven't been into baseball for a while. I need to get back into that. Esther, you know that I have breaking news.
What is it?
I today signed a lease to move out of the apartment.
Brody, how could you do this to me on air?
I'm sorry, but I had to find a one bedroom.
Oh my God, Brody, what? When? Where? You didn't even ask me first? Is there a place for me?
I mean, you could visit.
Is there another location? Is there another apartment in the building?
This is out in the valley. I moved to the valley.
When?
I got the keys today.
Brody, are you moving in this in November?
Yes.
Oh my God.
I'm sorry, but I have to get back to the valley. Hollywood's too much for me. It's like the tour vans, everybody's an actor or an actress, everyone's in a rock band, everyone's a tourist, everyone's weird. That energy, the homeless energy, it lofts over the desperation energy.
It's just negative. It's
you
just
guys,
gross.
Stop it. No, it's about stardom and Marilyn Monroe's body dust.
Yeah, you know what? I like going to Faux City without feeling like I'm going to get attacked by a heroin addict.
First of all, Faux City is disgusting.
It's not a peaceful energy.
You disgusting person.
I've been there, Faux City. It's not that bad.
I went there once with a weird guy.
They have free Wi-Fi, and it's not expensive, and the food's semi-healthy.
Yeah.
It looks like it. I've thought for 3 years that that was a photo developing store. For 3 years, until someone was like, I want to go there. And then I was like, yeah, we'll take pictures.
Anyway. Your pictures are good. Your tweets are good.
Thank you, Brody.
I'm seeing really positive things for you, and I think the comedians are pulling for you. And
Brody, don't leave.
I'm pulling for you. I have to.
No, Brody.
My place with no furniture.
Show me that lease. I'll rip it up.
No, Esther.
I'll throw it in the fire.
I have to leave.
Do you have street parking?
No, I have two parking spots, subterranean. Two.
One for me? JK.
Subterranean.
Where is it?
It's in the valley. I'm not going to give the exact address.
Why but not?
It's near where I used to live.
Brian just farted, okay? We're not going to overlook it.
Oh, we're doing fart humor. All right, good night, everybody. My name is Stephen Brody Stevens.
He did it, okay?
I just farted.
Well, I got yelled at for burping last week. I
farted in the mic.
Did you not fart in the mic, though,
right? I didn't fart in the mic. I farted.
Yeah, but your ass is in front of the mic. Okay?
No, it's not.
No, your ass isn't in front of the mic. My mouth is in front of the mic.
Okay? I'd rather hear the sound of a fart than a burp into the mic.
Yeah. Because farts are cute.
A fart not into They're the not, mic.
Whoa. Burps are cuter than farts, and that's for sure.
No. Farts are cute.
Brody?
This is, you know, pretty lowbrow humor, and...
we're allowed once... I mean, it came up naturally.
Yeah, this is a fun show. This is like a kid show.
Doesn't smell natural.
Can I just...
Ew, you're a sicko pervert. I don't know why.
To me, this is like... I'm still in pre-show mode. I'm in pre-show mode. I just need to say one... I just need to clear my head on one thing.
Okay.
And then we'll move on. People like my when I'm on, you know, I do Ice House Chronicles, and I'll bring that energy. I get, you know, that's the Brody energy. And then I have my own podcast where I do more of a Charlie Rose or the guy from the Actor Studio or just a friend, just two friends talking. And people seem to like that. And then I come on here. It's like my relationship with Esther. I like how Brian's involved now. And I don't want to feel like, you know, I have to perform. I'm just, this is another side of Brody you're seeing. I could deal with, you know, female energy. I have Esther. I'm dealing with that. She's young. She's hip. She's a go-getter. Brian's on the show. He's like, you know, with Death Squad and the positive energy and giving confidence to me. So I'm going to keep doing what I'm doing. I did smoke pot. I did. I'm completely open with you. And I have some more shocking and developing news, which will be released on my podcast very soon.
What, Brody? Brody, tell us.
You give us a hint.
Well, I mentioned it on the podcast the other day.
Oh.
A girl?
No.
Hangover 3?
No. I said I was 10% gay.
Oh, right.
What? What does that mean? What?
That means if there was 10 guys and standing in a row, he'd
Brody
probably
have sex with
fuck
one
of them.
No, no, it's not that at all. It's not that at all. All
right, so there was...
I went to Bangkok and I took it as far as I can go. I pushed it in terms of what I would do sexually, like even taboo stuff. I went to Bangkok and I pushed it as far as I could go. So I know in my head, like, I had an opportunity, I could do whatever I want, and I didn't do it. I wanted to see, like, Brody, are you gay? But the fact that I even attempted that has got to mean something.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
No, it doesn't.
Well, that's where I've seen.
No.
I could make, you know what, Esther? They say, like, don't think of a pink elephant. What do you think of? A pink elephant.
Yeah.
It's like, when you're a method actor like me and open-minded, somebody can, like, stick a video in front of your face and you have the opportunity to look at it.
I was thinking you were going to say after stick.
I've seen gay porn before.
Yeah? So is everybody?
No. I don't know. Why? I mean, I go on YouPorn and I've clicked over there.
That's fine.
Yeah, well, it doesn't mean. I mean, what straight guy does that? What real 100% straight guy does that?
I know a comedian who's very popular and has his own show, and he said that he once masturbated to two dudes just to so that he would not be homophobic.
Oh, okay, that's kind of like what I was doing.
What do you see when you see this? Do you like what you see?
No. I'm not, I don't, I have no desire to do that.
What was that test? You idiot, what was that test?
That's a desk squad. Somebody was a desk squad fan and some other.
Oh, I see it. Oh, I see it. That's funny.
What do you, do you like what you see?
Do you like what that though? Do you like?
No, I'm not, no, I have no desire to do that.
That looks like a woman in the.
I have no desire to do that.
All right. So you want to just lay on top of that? Just for
no, not at all.
Brody.
Not at all.
Look, well, then you're not 10% gay. I don't think.
Tell me this about this comedian guy.
He's a great guy. He has a great girlfriend. He's successful. He's one of my favorite comedians, and he's actually open about it. But I don't want to use anyone's name because I got in trouble last time. But he said that he jerked off to gay guys to prove that he wasn't homophobic.
Oh, like, you're talking about Carlos.
No, I'm not talking about Carlos.
Carlos.
Carlos is not in his own television show.
Oh, that Carlos. Okay, go ahead. Keep going.
No, he just said, I don't want to be homophobic, so I jerked off to dudes. And honestly, I don't want to close down and shut down your feelings, but I'm going to be sisterly here and just say what, you know, I feel the contrarian sister would say, and is that I don't believe you. I don't think you're 10% gay.
I might try to hold your hand and see what you feel.
No, I don't physically want to be with a man.
Right.
And I have no desire. I'm saying I've seen it before, and I can, like, my mind would wander, and I would look at it.
That's just a sexual curiosity. That's not.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with that.
I masturbate to girls.
I mean, I've
watched. But it's different if you're a girl.
No, it's not.
I've looked at porn and clicked on gay porn and just like, oh God, what is he? Ugh, you know. And I turned it. I didn't sit there and like watch the whole.
But it
thing,
would be be so wrong to watch. It's like a taboo thing.
Yeah. Who? Yeah, but, here's the test. This is what you
give,
ask.
Yeah, give me the test.
Here's the test. Here's what girls ask. Girls are like, I want to kiss another girl for attention. Okay, would you go down another girl? And they say no. They're not gay. They just want attention.
Okay.
Would you give a guy a blowjob?
Absolutely not.
Then
never
you're
have.
Not gay and you just want attention, like the girls.
Oh, God. That makes me feel better.
Well,
ask me some more questions.
Would you... would you rather... I don't know. Here's the test. Here's a physical test.
What are you doing, Brian?
Putting your hand.
Brody, you're why not you hold, gay.
Why are you holding my hand?
Look at you. You're tall. You have a. You're fit. You're not gay, Brody. Okay, nobody believes it. You're not fucking gay. You're a straight guy who wants to have sex with a woman.
Yes, you're correct.
Yeah, I know. You're not gay.
Once I get my libido back.
Yeah, you're not gay. You
Brian, just, that didn't make me feel good. See.
You just because. I've
but that
scared.
Says I'm like, I'm not man, you know, but if I was a regular guy, I wouldn't
no,
let that bother
that's
me.
Homophobes. Homophobes would be bothered by that and scared. But you're just like, oh, maybe you're not gay, okay? I've gotten off to women before and I've been like, oh my God, am I a lesbian? But then I'm like, no, I like having sex with men, so I'm not a lesbian.
And I like having sex with women, and they're out there.
Yeah, you're not gay. Would you let a guy put his dick in your butt?
No.
Okay, then you're not gay. What, I don't understand how you thought you're gay.
What about just the tip?
Cause no.
What about just rubbing?
I let a girl use a strap on.
Whoa.
That's fine.
I haven't had that fantasy for the last few years.
But you wanted that?
Wow.
Wait, hello? Two? Check? Check? Is this check two? No, I don't think that's gay at all. I've seen I've watched those videos. Joey Silvera does those videos.
It's technically not gay because it's sex with a woman.
Now, so when you went overseas.
Yeah, I don't want to be with a guy. I don't want to make
then
out with a guy.
You're not 10% gay. You just jerked off to gay guys once.
When you went overseas, maybe. Did you like kiss a ladyboy or anything like that? Or did you?
Eight times.
Eight times?
No, probably more. Check my cookies. At least I'm being open about this.
Yeah, I think that this is a great thing to talk about because I'm sure that other dudes are into it too. I've also heard that isn't like tranny porn really popular among men?
No, I think the
yes,
new,
it is.
I think that, yeah. Well, I think the new thing is thank instead you. Of Whew. Watching two girls fuck is to watch a tranny and a girl fuck. So that way you get like two girls,
four
but she's also getting fucking cock in her.
Right,
you
know? Four sets of tits yeah. or four. Four boobs.
And you know what? I'm glad we're talking about this right now. This is the show. This is the time. This is the right mixture of people for me to be open about.
It's true. I just want to know, who are the people you've been telling you're 10% gay, and they're not like calling?
I did on my other podcast, the Stephen Brody Stevens Festival of Friendship.
Who told you that? Who wasn't there to be like, no, you're not gay?
I labeled myself 10% gay.
I know, but
who was not telling you that you're wrong?
You're not gay. Or who was telling you? If you were, guess what? It would be great, and we would love it, and you and I could start going shopping for purses and stuff, but I don't think you're gay.
Okay, let me ask a question. When that podcast is released, you weren't there. The way you've handled this topic, same thing with you, Brian. If I played my cards right, I should have probably came out on this show.
Yes.
With the 10% gay. But I did it on...
You did come out on this show.
Right, came out.
Yeah. Well, you didn't come out.
I'm 10% gay.
You're not. You're not. There's no coming out. It's like a lie. It's like, is this a publicity stunt? If so, I'm into it.
Brian, I used to mention a ladyboy, and you said something else about something.
Yeah.
Else.
Well, I mean, did you play around with a ladyboy? Did you have like a little Asian boy that was dressed up as a girl that had a dick, and then you like rolled around in the sheets? Or
what?
You
know? Okay. First of all, let me ask a question. Yeah. What are my options on that?
Yes, you did experiment with a ladyboy.
What's a
no,
ladyboy?
No, you didn't. Or three, you went to do it, but then at the last minute, you just wanted him to spit on your dick or something like that.
But if you did do it with, if you did something with a ladyboy.
Got a blowjob is what you're saying? Or put it in his butt?
Anything.
You put it in his butt?
He gave you a blowjob.
So let me ask a question.
What if you didn't know? I mean, did you know?
What does that make you?
I think if you wanted to try it out and the ladyboy was somewhat cute, I would say if you...
Now, describe a ladyboy.
I wouldn't do it. Ladyboy is a Asian that looks like a woman, but it's actually a tranny. It's a boy because all Asians are like all kind of, you know...
Feminine.
What's a tranny? Describe a tranny.
Wait, can someone just make sure we have that quote from Brian Redband? All Asians are feminine.
No, I mean, they have nice, they all have soft, nice faces. Like, even the guys, you put a wig on them, you're like, oh, that could be a cute girl.
Right.
Like, no Asians have, like, rugged beards, and they're just like, hey, you know? Like, it's mostly, they're all very clean cut and very... very young looking, you know what I mean? And God,
you're
I'm 10% gay.
He's 10% gay. You're Gaysian. You're gay for Asians.
I'm gay for Asians.
So what? Okay. So what is a tranny? Describe a tranny.
A tranny is a guy. It's like a tranny is like if Brian dressed up as a woman. Then he's a tranny.
Yeah.
If you dress up as a woman, you're a tranny.
Wait. Okay.
So if you have sex with a tranny, does that mean you're gay? No, I think it just means you're not a homophobe.
Describe it. Okay, I like your answer.
Yeah.
Describe the tranny again for me.
The tranny is a man.
A man.
In like lipstick and high heels and a cute dress with like a great body and
body hair usually.
Like good muscles, you know.
When you say good body, what do you mean by that?
Just like a thinner.
Do they have breasts?
No.
Sometimes.
Sometimes, but most of them are just like really thin and they just look like they have no boobs and
they look like hot chicks. Yeah. I mean, I live in West Hollywood. I see women who you're not sure if they're really a man or not.
What if they looked like, and they had breasts.
Yeah.
Taking the hormones.
Yeah.
Still have the dick, but yeah.
I'm a tranny. I'm just kidding.
And I had, you know,
why
what?
Why didn't anyone respond?
I had the opportunity to do whatever I wanted, and I didn't do I didn't do those things when I had the opportunity. It proved
you didn't
to me,
do most of those.
It proved
things.
To me that I'm not gay, but I did. I mean, the fact that
like it looked like something like this. Like,
oh, she's hot.
Well, that's a guy.
What?
Gay.
But it'd be something like that where, yes, she had some kind of boob thing going on here.
Right.
It looks like maybe a B cup.
See, trannies have...
Okay, breasts.
See, trannies have like those hot shoulders that women, it's hard for women to have. At least me, I'm
around.
And
I mean, then altogether, it looks like a pretty hot Asian girl, but she has a dick.
Yeah, but you know what? Okay.
Brian knows because he fucked her.
Let me say this.
No.
Let me say this. What happens if the penis was like shriveled up?
like was dying. Like she was doing some kind of like shit to like get rid of it, and it was almost about to fall off. Is that what you're saying?
Like, dumbest thing I've ever.
No, it's like Dr. Scholl's, right? Like they just put like some shit on it and it just gets.
No, no, but don't.
About to fall off? That doesn't. You mean a transgender? They're getting a surgery.
Well, I mean, I think ideally that's what they want to do. Some of them.
Yeah.
But this.
So no boner during this whole time. It was like soft and small.
Look, Brody, it's like we're trying to solve a riddle when you have the answer the whole time. Yeah. Just spill it out. Let us in. Tell us what happened.
All right, tell us where you met her. You met her on the
and
streets.
And when were you in?
I'm not gonna. Oh, but
when were you in Bangkok?
For Hangover 2.
So this is
old news. And I'm not gonna get Hangover 3. It looks like.
Because that's you just were out getting sucked all night, and they couldn't find you all the
time.
This
is old news.
Thanks a lot, Brian. See, I'm gonna get gay bash.
I'm just kidding.
No, you. So you are you saying like you accepted some sexual favors from the boy?
Possibly. What does that tell me the results and what label would be put on me?
I just think that you're experimental and you're not a homophobe.
I would say that you wanted to try it out for whatever reason because you have this Asian thing and there was some Asian
thing.
Yeah, but those Asian boys are everywhere.
He's not in a relationship. He's not having sex regularly, so it's
with
like
anybody.
Yeah, but those ladyboys are everywhere, am I right? When you go to Bangkok, ladyboys are just...
It's an accepted part of the culture.
Yeah, you are in a different culture. Right. It's not... That doesn't mean you're gay. Like I said, you're not... And I think that's a healthy attitude to have. You shouldn't be homophobic about it. And if you want to experiment... I mean, I'm not supporting hookerism or whatever, but I just think what you did is okay. And I definitely think you're not gay, and I...
No matter what I did... With this thing.
Did you like lick his ass?
No.
Then I don't think you're gay.
Oh, okay, good.
Also, 10% is like nothing.
Well.
And there's no, I don't want to say there's no such thing because I could say I'm 10% gay and that would make more sense. But I just, you're not gay. You're straight.
But I walk like I'm gay.
No, you don't.
No, you don't.
You do not walk like you're gay. Just because someone told you that in high school does not mean that. And there's no such thing as walking like you're gay. That's
racist. I can see.
Yeah, there's
no. You could see guys and they go, "This guy's gay."
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
Are you Esther? Are you that? You're Come on.
If you're walking, you mean like a woman, like hip side to side,
like Natasha Leggero at Macy's.
No. Well, there's that. But there's guys who look athletic, even athletic guys.
Yeah, you look athletic.
Okay, but how they walk, some of them walk. You can tell they're gay. It's like a gay walk. Not like flamboyant gay, just like their gait, a gay gait. And I feel like I fall into that category.
You do not walk gay. I've never looked at you walk and think that you walk gay.
But you're not into sports, Brian.
And I also don't think you... It's not like you walk sucking dicks. Like,
no.
You're not walking gay. Then you're not walking gay. You're walking...
I've been told I walk gay.
Well, you need to get it out of your head and move on from those bullies. Because bullyism is really
serious. Somebody tell you that in high school?
Yeah.
When and college and after college.
Well,
they
your
were
jocks
just trying
told
to pick
you
on
that,
you
because
right?
you
no, were
No, girls too.
Them.
Girls too.
In college, girls said that you walked... What kind of college was this?
Can I tell
I've
you
gotten
something?
It after college.
Brody, can I tell you something? Sometimes people want to be funny and they don't know how to be funny, so they get mean.
Do you know any girl comedians? There's probably like 5 of them who have accused me of being gay.
Like who? That's because they wanted to probably hook up with you.
I think...
You know what you do when they say that?
No,
you fucking shove their face in your crotch and like, yeah, see how gay this is.
No,
just,
well,
I'm not a violent
that's
aggressive.
That's rape.
That's sexual assault,
rape?
Brian.
Yeah.
That's rape of the mouth.
They're testing you.
No, if they... First of all, what was the situation? Maybe they were like, why isn't he hitting on me? And it's because you're a gentleman. And then they're like, he must be gay because I'm insecure.
No, I got him. You know what? I'm not gay. And I'd like to have a relationship with a woman. I'm maturing. And I got the new apartment. I feel good. I do the pod. I'm thankful that I'm getting to do the podcast.
You should have moved to Koreatown, by the way.
No.
What?
I'm happy being
idea.
In the Valley, and I can get to the Comedy Store.
But in Koreatown,
in
there's ladyboys.
No, I'm saying in Koreatown, there's Asians, and I think
I like how you do that sound. That's a good sound. You should put. Do you have that on your resume? Like you can do those kind of sounds?
No, I don't have a resume.
How do you not have a resume?
I don't know. I threw it away like a year ago. and I got a new computer and I just lost it.
Have you ever seen Aiko Tanaka's resume, by the way? Speaking of resumes, they had it on the Ding Dong Show. She has a piece of paper that she just writes like, Aiko Tanaka is very funny and she works hard. And she just gives like this like piece of notebook paper to Jobs, and it works. Like, they don't. She doesn't type it out normal.
What jobs has she gotten with it?
Just restaurant jobs, but
she's good energy.
Oh,
we went hiking with her today. We saw her up there. She's funny.
Yeah,
and she's good. Like when I drum in the band, the chair drumming, whenever she's there with the tambourine, it makes it like it makes me keep up.
Do you get flashbacks? Not Bangkok.
Oh. Do. No, but I knew I took it as far as I could go, like how as far as I could mentally accept it and physically accept it. And I know walking out of that room that night in Bangkok that I wasn't gay. But
yeah,
I did come up with the number percentage, 10%, based on the gay pornography and my mannerisms.
Was there an algorithm that we can use to get to our own percentages? And mannerisms is not, it's not, that doesn't count, okay?
Well, how come Evan's had a serious girlfriend?
Because you're shy and you don't hit on women.
You're right.
You are focused so hard on comedy and stuff like that. I mean, do you even have any time where you're...
mental stuff?
Can girls DM me, please?
Are you on OkCupid or J-Date?
I haven't checked that site. I got to be attracted to the woman. You know,
maybe you're really picky.
I'm picky, but you know what? I met a cute girl last week down in Irvine. Who emailed me?
Well, did you email her back?
Forward.
Yes,
and
of
stop
course.
Telling people you're gay.
Well,
because that's gonna close you off. I wouldn't wanna hook up with a guy
bashed.
That. No, you're not. No one here's bashing gay. We're just telling you you don't know what gay is.
Honestly, I don't know. I don't. I see why he's questioning himself, because he did get whatever. I'm guessing a blowjob and a finger up his butt.
No, I didn't get it. No, Brian, I did not.
Hey,
not from
a finger up the butt isn't gay. Okay, I'm not going to say anything specific. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well,
nobody's
you like
finger
it.
Went up my butt in Bangkok. Nobody. Girls would. I'm fine with that.
Did you put a finger up this person's butt while they were giving you a blowjob?
No.
It's not that, you know, also, sometimes there's, like we were saying, taboo is, like, that's sexually attractive. Sometimes, like, maybe if I think my roommate's going to come home, it gets more exciting when I'm alone.
I think you would be very interested in the bondage lifestyle here in Los Angeles. And just the S&M lifestyle, just the lifestyle. I mean, they have, you know, bars where they have like open people having sex in the open and you watch. You have things where, you know, you get tied up and you have a dominatrix. I think you would like that. That, and I think you'd be really into Asian girls. And I think Asian girls would be into you. They are looking
an
for
an athletic body.
Yeah, you have an athletic body. They're looking for funny people, Americans. I mean, they're out here by themselves, like fucking trying to survive, you know. And I think that'd
be a good segment on my HBO season 2. I go into bondage.
Yeah. Yeah. I could hook you up with that lifestyle. I know all those people. I know a couple dominatrixes. I know, you know, spanking people. I know bondage people. I think you'd like it, man. I think you'd.
Really, yeah, but I don't want to get my ass cheeks all
no, you
red.
Don't have to. You could be an observer, a person that watches or just goes to sex parties.
You know what I want to do? I'm going to tell you what I want to do.
I don't want to get my ass cheeks all red.
You don't want to, yeah.
I want to get lasered. I want to get my neck lasered so I don't have to shave. I want to get my cheeks lasered so I don't have to shave.
I don't think you should do that.
Why?
Because I don't think you need to.
It's a hassle shaving.
Yeah, you know, it's same for women.
Yeah, but...
I have to shave my beard every day. I don't complain.
Yeah,
I'm just kidding.
But
no, you're
Esther,
not.
You can have hair. You can have hairy legs and it's not going to affect your work.
Oh.
Well...
It probably does.
No.
Yeah, because...
Because what?
Why would it?
I don't know. If she meets somebody that was going to hire her for something and they see her legs, they're probably like, ew.
Well, she'll wear pants. For the most part, she can let her leg hair grow.
Yeah, but my mustache gets in the way.
What? Oh, you really get a mustache?
Yeah, yeah. Everyone does. Hey,
what do you?
Don't answer for me. So, yeah, I have a mustache. I have, I just have like, my armpits are gross. I get armpit hair. When I shave my armpits and I get out of the shower after I shaved it, it grows back already.
Yeah.
And not to get too graphic, but.
Humongous bush.
No, that is disgusting. Don't say that. Okay.
Let's keep it clean.
No, whatever.
No, you're doing great, Esther.
I have some chest hair.
Are you serious?
Yeah. It's like a few. You just... It comes in patches.
Yeah, but you know what?
It got caught in between my teeth once and it pulled and plucked it.
That's disgusting, okay? Seriously, you're taking it too far. It's like you're drunk with power when you say that. Okay?
Esther, I want to say thank you for... you know, making me feel better about my openness.
You're welcome, and I want to say thank you for being open. I think it's brave, and I think it's important, and I think it's good to get things off your chest, like my hair, and I think it's good to, you know, just acknowledge your feelings, share them so that other people can relate. I'm sure there are plenty of listeners who've jerked off to guys before, and they're like, what's wrong with me? Nothing's wrong with you. You're just being maybe a homophobe about it if you think it's bad. But I think maybe there's something taboo about being a man and wanting to watch two men together and jerking off to it 8 times. I think that's completely healthy.
Oh, thank you. But I played baseball at Arizona State and not once. And I've been in clubhouses with the Yankees and the Dodgers and stuff. And I was never, like, aroused.
No, you're not
never.
Gay.
Never.
And even if you were, that would be fine. But
I wasn't.
But you weren't, so you're not gay.
I go to the gym. I would go to. I'm going to be joining 24-hour fitness. I'm going to have opportunities there to experiment again. It's like a little Bangkok.
Now, when you were in the car with Monkey Todd that one time, did you try to put the moves on him?
No.
Is that what happened that night?
Oh, you like I dosed him? Yeah. I dosed Monkey Todd. He got into my Lamictal, which I'm at a therapeutic dose. You know, it's like, I just got to be careful with the pot. You know, I think the Lamictal's been helping me. Structure's been helping me. I don't want to get overwhelmed with this move. I like, you know, I could talk. But, Esther, are you checking Twitter?
A little, but nothing. I'm done. I don't want to look at it right now.
See, our thing is
but
like
I will read tweets from people about this.
And I'm going to let you guys talk because I got to check my texts and Twitter too. This show is just another angle of us.
Yeah.
You know, you're great. You can do stand-up comedy. You can do funny tweets. You can act. You've been in commercials. You've been on popular TV shows. You have your own podcast. You have all that. This show is another angle of the who you are, right? Same goes for me.
Yes.
Okay.
You have your HBO show.
Yes, I have.
You have your live performances in LA.
In the moment.
You have your live performances on the road.
I go out on the road.
You have your.
I do audience warm-up.
Your Twitter, your and podcast,
my Twitter,
your
my
audience
podcast,
warm-up.
Selling merchandise.
Yes, you have all these things, and this is another facet of those.
And people know us from those things, so they hear this, and it's like we don't even have to try to entertain. They just want to hear us talk.
Well, within reason.
Oh, okay. So you're telling me to pick it up a notch.
No. I was speaking about it myself. Sometimes I can get on tangents about like puppies and kitties and hedgehogs and stuff. Speaking of which.
You brought it.
Are you okay?
She kissed Pika. The Pika. Is it a Pika? What is that again?
Pika. No, this is a Webkinz. His name is Sprinkles.
Webkinz.
He's a boy.
I'm going to check my texts. I'm not going anywhere.
So you don't know what a Pikachu is.
Brody, you don't know what a Pikachu is?
I've heard of them. Wait, my friends are Joe Wagner. Let's see what these guys have said.
A Pikachu used to live in my closet. It was fun.
Okay, here. Okay, this is what Joe Wagner. You guys know him? He's very funny.
Uh-huh.
He wrote and helped produce Brody Stevens Enjoy It on
uh-huh.
HBO. He's written on a whole bunch of shows.
Okay.
He's a funny guy. He's a friend. Joe Wagner. Do you know him?
I don't know him, but I know of him through you.
Brian, have you met Joe Wagner?
Yeah.
You have? Where?
I think he come here with you when you filmed at the studio? Is that who it was?
Probably, maybe. No, that was Tom Sharp. Another guy
maybe
who
I know.
Worked on the HBO
probably, maybe.
Go.
Probably hey, man. I just
Enjoy
met
it.
You.
Okay, so he says, 10%, I'm with Esther. This is just a sensationalist podcast ploy for ratings. I watch videos of dudes getting effed. Oh, I don't know if I should say this.
You're outing.
You're just acknowledge your sexual open. 10% gay equals 10% spike in ratings. Publicity stunt. You don't walk like you're gay. You run like you're gay. Bangkok ass munchers. That wasn't a gay video. Ass munchers. 10% gay, 20% funny. That one hurts. That was Joe Wagner, who's a good writer, and he's listening at home. So, Esther, have you been hiking and exercising?
I haven't been hiking. I have been doing some dancing stuff on my own.
You guys want to see something fucking crazy that somebody just tweeted me? It's pretty ridiculous. Sure. It's a drunk Demi Moore.
Oh, really?
Kissing a 14-year-old kid when she was 19 at the time. And it's pretty ridiculous. We'll start off here with the first kiss.
Oh, that's awkward.
Which is, yeah, it's just, I mean, look at that. That's,
oh, gross.
Whoa, she was hot.
And then there's the second kiss at 1:49.
Is that Ashton Kutcher?
No. And then there's a third.
She's 19 there. She's beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh.
You're going to get married, by the way. Don't let her husband find out.
I can't wait.
This guy sits courtside at Laker games.
I said that's kind of crazy.
God, that is weird.
I'm 10% gay for Demi Moore.
And then look at her, you know, dating Ashton, you know, who is a lot younger. Awesome.
Well, now he's dating Mila. So she likes younger guys. Who cares?
Yeah, 14-year-olds.
That's that. They weren't fucking. She just kissed him because he.
That was a pretty passionate kiss.
But what was the story behind it? Like, was he a fan? Was he dying of
cancer? I think they were both on a TV show together, General Hospital or something like that.
I think lip kisses can go either way. I think.
I don't want to lip kiss a guy.
I.
What does that say?
We already know what you're.
Oh, you're saying move on.
I mean,
I went through something very traumatic.
I understand that. You know what? Can I tell you something? I went through something traumatic similar. When I was a kid, I thought I was gay and that everyone was going to find out about it. And I was really traumatic and it's not funny. So I shouldn't even be talking about it on a podcast.
Yes, you can. It's real.
But I know it can be scary. And no one should feel scared or ashamed of their sexuality. Like, who cares if you like things in your butt? Who cares if you like it when people spit in your mouth? Whatever, you know? Not...
Well, I get that.
Who cares if... I don't know. I just feel like we... I have a really progressive attitude about sex, and I think everyone should.
What's Brian's attitude?
I don't know. He's busy looking at his iPhone 5. Is it freezing?
No.
No, it's not freezing in here.
No, it's iPhone 5.
I'm hot. Is it hot in here?
I meant your iPhone 5, stupid idiot.
Esther, you are very aggressive.
Sorry.
Are you going to miss... having me in the apartment complex? I'm gonna miss seeing you.
Yeah, that's why I'm gonna rip up your lease. I'm gonna break into your apartment and rip up the lease.
I have a balcony.
What?
I have a microwave built in above
the. Don't use the microwave, it's bad for you.
Well, sometimes, yeah, you're right. Obviously, you know, but it's semi safe.
Yeah, once in a while.
Once in a while, okay.
I love macaroni and cheese.
But I have a great water pressure.
We have great water pressure.
This is better.
Whoa.
It's better water pressure.
Take the knife out of my back.
And it's a step-down living room. You walk in and you go down two steps into the living room. And I've got the back balcony off the street. And I can afford it for like a year. And then I'll probably have to move back home with my sister after that. But...
I don't want to be all alone. Me and Sprinkles are going to be unsafe.
I'm sorry, Sprinkles. I'm sorry, Sprinkles. Little Sprinkles.
I'm going out of town this weekend, so I'm looking for a sitter for Sprinkles. They don't allow dogs where I'm going.
Where are you going, Esther?
I'm going to...
You can't tell us.
I'm going to prison.
You're going to prison?
Yeah, anywhere away from Sprinkles is a prison. Meow. Brian, we lost you. What are you doing?
I'm sweating my ass off.
You're dressed as a Pikachu. Is this a Halloween costume or a new lifestyle change?
It's a Halloween costume, but it was supposed to come Friday, and then I just got it today.
Yeah. I love it. I'm going to get it. I'm into it.
Do you want me to... can I check my Twitter?
Yeah.
You don't mind?
No. You can.
Let me check my Twitter.
We can, have you guys heard the new Death Squad rap that you guys are all in?
Yeah, no, it was good. I'd love to hear it again.
I've never heard it.
It's actually pretty good.
Is this Thrift Stop? Thrift Store?
No.
Death squads in the house, ain't no kicking them out. It's Joey motherfucking Diaz with a dick in your mouth. We're dancing in a drum circle doing the hippie shuffle. Now we're traveling to different dimensions with Duncan Trussell. We meditate and send our intentions to help the hungry, while our government spends our money bombing another country. We got Red Baron running all the technical shit, chilling with porn stars, taking ecstasy hits. If the Holocaust happened again, who would survive? Ari Shaffir, the funniest Jew alive. Born with a gold dick, fuck your membership at Gold's Gym. No concentration camp could hold him. The CIA imports the coke and speed, and then you try to fuck with me just for smoking some weed. Let me get this straight so I can hear what you say. You tell me marijuana's bad, but Oxycontin's okay. What? They help perpetuate this fake war on drugs, so the pharmaceutical companies can score more bucks. I'm chilling with Brody Stevens, feeling oh so fresh. Positive energy, enjoy it, yes. If they play a show in your town, you better take a trip to see Doug Stanhope or Sam Tripoli. I can't describe the complex things I've seen, just from meditation and some dimethyltryptamine. Life is just a dream, it switches different scenes, a simulation from the symmetry within our genes. I'm so high it's kinda like I'm smoking God's hash, and then I take a long bath and listen to the podcast. Go to JoeRogan.net and check who's next on. Will it be Brian Callen, Brendan Walsh, or John Heffron? Shout out to Little Esther, you know you can't hide. What up, and girl? Shout out to all the Death Squad fans worldwide. And also Tate Fletcher, that dude's a shit too. And Eddie Bravo, 10th Planet Jiu-Jitsu. He's a fighter, a teacher.
Yeah, so anyways, check that out. It's on the YouTube page. It's called Bliss Hip Hop 1. Bliss.
That's got to have a lot of hits. I would say 40,000 hits.
235 views.
That's it?
Yeah. I've just only talked about it today, though, so...
I need more time, more airtime for Little Esther on that rap. There needs to be more of me in it.
Yeah.
That's my one critique. Otherwise, it's wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I met the guy in Minneapolis. He gave me a CD. And so many people give me CDs, and I just have piles of them. And then I actually listened to that, and I was like, wow, that's actually pretty good. I like the Brody Stevens part the best.
That's a cool rap. Are you going to tweet that again? I'll tweet it.
I tweeted it today. Okay. So
I'm just checking Twitter right now. I'll be right back. I'm playing to the podcast.
You know what's really stressful and weird about this Halloween is that everyone's been talking about pumpkin, but nobody's talked about caramel apples once, and Halloween is 2 days away.
I like caramel apples, but I eat them all year long because my grocery store sells them.
Can we go get caramel apples after this?
Yeah, if you want to. Well, I can't.
Why?
Because I got plans.
Whoa. Yeah, right. We're doing it.
You have plans?
Yeah.
No.
Tonight?
Yeah.
But I don't have any plans.
Yeah, right.
I don't. I have nothing to do.
I don't have anything to do. I have no plans.
I don't. I was going to hang out with me. Some sprinkles. No. I don't want to go to the comedy store. They're going to hurt me.
Are you guys going to the Halloween party at the comedy store Wednesday?
I wasn't invited.
Is that Pauly Shore's?
I don't know. I guess Pauly Shore's having a Halloween party. And then they're going to have like the belly room's going to be like a VIP lounge area with like a DJ and stuff like that.
Ew. Over it.
Yeah. I think, do you guys go into Halloween?
I'm not. I you know what?
No.
I've never been one to dress up for Halloween. I'll tell you why.
I'm an adult. I think it's a kid's holiday. JK.
It's
I'll eat candy. I would trick-or-treat if it was allowed, but I don't want to put a costume on.
You could probably get away with trick-or-treating. Didn't you do that 1 year? When we were first met. Yeah.
Yeah, but I would need like a small child or a large adult to offset.
I think as a comedian and somebody who is you know, all of our energy is in, you would think a lot of it is into the arts. It's like this is the one day for the non-comedians, the non-artists to dress up and have their day. I know I'm all kind of a lot. I mean, I think a lot of people think that way, but they still dress up. You know, there's celebrities who dress up all the time for parties. Don't you think? Like famous celebrity actors or... I'm sure there's funny celebrity comedians, famous comedians who dress up and did a Halloween party.
Yeah, I think people dress up. I went to a party on Saturday night, but no, it was, there was famous celebrity comedians there. No one was dressed up. It was an adult party. I think it's fun to dress up, and if you have a costume you want and you have the right friend group, but I haven't dressed up in a long time. I'll wear my footy pajamas, but that's just like a throwaway because I wear those on non-Halloween days.
I don't know what this says about me. Like, do I have Asperger's? Do I have adult onset autism? I may have mentioned that before in a podcast, but.
You might. Yeah.
You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I have no desire to dress up for Halloween.
I'll say I don't think that has anything to do with those things that have anything to do with each other, but I think that both could be separately.
I mean, I didn't go to prom. I don't dress up for Halloween. I didn't get bar mitzvahed.
I went to prom twice.
Yeah, I was not confused. I was so like shy, painfully shy about things. I just feel like me being a sexual being in front of my dad or my mom kind of like creeped me out a little bit. Like having them think of me having sex.
Yeah, that sounds like you had a pretty repressed childhood.
Yeah, or maybe I'm just genetically messed up. Psychologically.
I don't think messed up is really an accurate diagnosis, but I think that, I don't know, some families are more closed off and some are more open. I think it's fine. But I mean, I also don't think we should dwell on that. I mean, you're well beyond that.
I'll say this.
Incidents.
I'll say this. There are several successful, funny, respected comedians out there.
Yeah. I clogged the toilet at my senior prom. Go ahead.
Who are married with children happily. They did it. Where were they messed up? Because they say to be a great comedian, it's great to have a messed up childhood or a messed up.
No, we were just talking about Halloween, so I don't know how we got here, but I'm going to roll with it. You don't have to have a messed up childhood, no. But usually people who come from good homes don't need, they're like too scared to do something like quit school or try stand up or be an actor or be a waiter, you know, for 5 years, 10 years. Usually those people go to college and they get a job and then they move up in their job and then they buy a nice car and they watch American Idol with their family.
That's what most people do.
Yeah. If they're lucky, that sounds like that's a good life.
But Esther, my father died thinking I was probably a virgin, where I've already had sex with like 4 or 5 women by the time he died.
Okay. So?
And I didn't go to prom. You know, those things like when people said, you know, I got picked on a lot.
So what? So many people choose to not go to prom. Who cares if you didn't go to prom?
I didn't go to prom because I didn't have confidence.
But that was like 20 years ago.
25 probably.
But get over it. Who cares? I didn't have a bat mitzvah.
But what I'm saying is maybe it's affecting me later in life now. It's coming back to haunt me because I didn't go through those check marks in life.
I think if people can overcome like rape and like seeing their dad kill their mom, you could probably overcome not going to prom. I had some things.
How many people see their parents killed?
I know one girl who's really obnoxious, and then I found out that that's what happened. And so it's okay.
Sad
fine.
Thing.
Yeah.
But that wouldn't be under a normal case.
No, it wouldn't. I just think that you can move on from not going to prom. I think it's time to move on, you know?
Okay.
I don't think that's really that traumatic. My sister went 4 times. I only went twice. That kind of sucked.
But Alicia went twice.
People in homeschool don't even have proms. Homecoming, they don't even have, you know, friends. I know a lot of people that have been homeschooled and they don't get any of
that. My prom date was gay.
Really?
Yeah, I had a gay prom date.
My mom's 81 and still thinks that I'm probably a virgin. She can't picture me having sex
with
a woman.
That's okay.
Send her a couple videos.
No. Just don't. You don't have to talk about it.
What do you mean don't talk about it?
She doesn't have to know. That's okay.
I want to be like normal guys.
I mean, what is normal?
To say that, mom, this is a chick with me, and I have sex with her.
No, that's not, you could just say this is my woman.
My girlfriend.
Yeah, you don't have to say.
We're going to sleep on the couch tonight and have sex.
No, you don't have to just leave the sex part.
Yeah, you don't have to say that. Some people, when they go visit their parents, they sleep in separate rooms. Like,
right. Just don't clean up after you have sex, and then she'll find it the next day.
I'm immature like that. I got real issues with that, and I need to.
That's okay. You can break through it.
I'm a fixer-upper.
Right.
I need a girl to walk me through these steps.
There's plenty of women like that. I've dated fixer-uppers.
I'm a fixer-upper.
I'm a fixer-upper.
Wow.
Everyone.
Birds of a feather flock together.
We should fix somebody tonight.
Bangkok, here we come.
Esther, how was your weekend? We can say that because it's Monday right now.
I had a good weekend. I went to a fun party, and I went to a good dinner, and I got sick on Friday.
You did? What kind of sick?
I got a little food sick. I'd rather not get into it. But starting Saturday, my weekend was fun.
I went to that Day of the Dead thing at the Hollywood Cemetery.
What's that?
Day of the Dead. It's like
Dia de los Muertos?
Yeah. And it was insane. It was panicky, stressful. Just way too many fucking people. And then there was a point where I couldn't walk any direction. I was stuck. I just had to stand there and be like, what the fuck? Why is no one walking? It was really
That sounds like the
panicky.
Kris Kringle Festival. Yeah, it's this weird thing in Chicago my mom made me go to once, and I didn't talk to her for weeks after.
So this guy wrote, watching you now online, congrats on not being gay. Still not a fan, but this could change. I haven't ruled it out. Why would you tell somebody you're not a fan? Not a fan of you.
I don't know. I think that's fine.
Really? Well, I mean, it's not ruining my night.
No, it doesn't affect me when people...
Do you get hate tweets?
I used to get a lot more. I don't really get any now. I get a few, and I'm just over. I don't care.
When do you get a hate tweet, and who would do it?
My parents have done it.
Your parents hate tweeted you?
No, they just hate life me. Hate life. You know what? Oh, this is... If we're going to share some things that you feel traumatic about, I was out with a friend, and... I met one of my friend's parents, and everything that he said, they laughed. My parents have never laughed at anything I've ever said. And I know this is me opening up a realm for people to say it's because you're not funny, but
you're funny.
Thank you. But my parents don't think anything I say is funny. And even if I say something that's just without a doubt funny, they think it's gross or they'll roll their eyes. My parents don't think I'm funny. And I was shocked to see my friend's parents laugh at jokes he made. I couldn't believe it. Do your parents think you're funny? Anyone?
Yeah.
My mom barely thinks I'm funny.
She laughed during your show. She thought you were funny. She watched you at your Conan set and said you were funny.
Yeah. My eyebrows are too, tweezed. I have OCD.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
What do you mean, yeah? They look tweezed?
No, yeah, you're OCD. You always ask me about your eyebrows. They're fine.
Don't yell at me, Esther.
I'm not yelling. I don't raise my voice. I don't like confrontation. I'm just trying to encourage you to be positive and confident.
Yeah, I have OCD. I feel like that I need things to be perfect sometimes. And I'm too hard on myself. So yeah. I feel my eyebrows have to be perfect.
Hey, I'm hard on myself. I ate a Chipotle burrito and ice cream, and then I felt really guilty for a long time. I should just get over it. People should be less hard on themselves. Give yourself a break. Who cares? Brian, stop.
Brian, don't do that to
me. No, we're not focusing on the video today. Stop it. Let's all, as a group of listeners and speakers, let's be less hard on ourselves. Everyone should just pat themselves on the back for one thing today. For me, I...
Look how bad my skin is.
Brody, stop.
Okay, would you say I have bad skin?
No.
I have pockmarks.
I have adult acne.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do.
Brody, leave it normal. Look at that.
Everyone should say something good they did today about themselves. Not on the podcast, but at home.
Brody, leave it normal.
If you're listening at home, think
now
about,
you're showing my bald spot.
Think about, hey, like, today I woke up and brushed my teeth. A round of applause.
Why are you showing my bald spot?
Today I got out of bed. Stop it, Brian. Today I got out of bed. Round of applause. Pat on the back.
Well, those are my shower. Eyes.
I ate a well-balanced breakfast. Important meal of the day. I made it to something on time. Even though I didn't, but you made it to something on time. You know, the audio listeners are just now hearing me ramble about how to pat yourself on the back, and they're going to just turn it off. Because you guys are... Stop it!
That's what little Esther's butt looks like.
Thank you so much. That's so sweet of you.
That's her mom.
That's what any wow, that's butt creepy. Looks like, stupid.
That looks like a hair lip.
It's a cool special effect.
It really is.
You what? What's this, what is the effect?
Children.
It's a mirror.
Look how big my nose is. Oh, man.
Now it looks like what Joey Diaz, a fly when he's looking at Joey Diaz.
So what? This is a special effect that they have on camera? We're looking at special effects, video effects. God, I look high. I got to get my beard trimmed like from there. See that?
Your apples. I like keeping the apples.
Is that what they're called, apples?
Yeah, these are your apples right here. And who, I like to keep the apples.
Who named them apples?
I think probably somebody like Shirley Temple or somebody.
So you say keep that?
Yeah, I like that.
Caramel apples.
You know, what I don't like? I don't like it when it's like a lot of you guys like, you know, like fine groom it and it's like always perfect, you know, everything's perfect.
I don't like that.
I want.
This is my personal preference.
I wish that it was like the 50s and like a nice gentleman would come pick me up and take me out and we'd like go get a caramel apple somewhere.
Like Don Draper from Mad Men.
I haven't seen that show and I think that's the 60s, but I would be open to it.
He's got great hair.
Where are you going, Brian? What? What are you doing?
Brian, what are you doing? Brian!
Stop! What are you doing? What are you trying to do?
Let me just see it.
No, you're going to hurt him. Stop.
Brian,
you can see him.
Don't assault Esther.
What do you want? No.
Brian, keep it positive.
You're going to hurt him and you're smoking cigarettes. I don't want him to be exposed to cigarettes this young.
Just kiss him. Let him kiss me real quick.
No hands. On the cheek.
Are you really crying, Esther?
You owe me.
That was a request.
You owe me millions of dollars in therapy for my dog.
Somebody requested me to do that.
Well, whoever they are, they're getting a hate shout out right now. This is your hate shout out for requesting that somebody assault my dog, who is so young, he hasn't even done shots yet.
So any new updates with Brie Olson? Showing your tits in the middle of the grocery store, I heard.
I didn't show my tits. I showed my vagina.
In a grocery store.
I showed it to her.
In a grocery store.
Yeah.
Why? Scare? You know, there's like kids in the grocery store, and you could get arrested for
not in that aisle, not at that time.
Yeah, but within a certain distance.
I didn't think that far ahead. I was just happy to be with my friend shopping.
And you were like, "Hey, look at this bush."
No. I don't want to be graphic.
Have you had sex with her yet, and her boyfriend?
You are disgusting.
All right, have you had sex with her?
She's my friend.
Have you had sex
with
her?
Who I happened to idolize for 3 years before we became friends. And no, we have not had sex. She has a boyfriend.
Have you messed around with her?
No.
Have you tasted Charlie Sheen?
You're disgusting, okay? No, she's my friend. Who I used to masturbate to.
And now do you find that you could still masturbate? Or are you masturbating on her?
Hey, come on, Brian.
Yeah, Brian.
You don't like to hear little Esther get dirty?
No. She's my friend, Brie Olson. She has a real name. Sometimes I call her by her real name. And I feel cool about it. And we text a lot. I text with her.
Have you ever picked her up like a six-pack?
What does that mean?
Nothing.
She's picked me up at my apartment before. She has a nice car. And a nice purse. I don't have a purse. I have a car that's not nice. And we hang out. We do things together that normal adults who are friends do. We go grocery shopping together. We walk together. We make plans. We go shopping. We mostly text. That's the modern day friendship, is just a lot of texting between women. I find that most of my friends and I just text. We don't really
see. Does she send you naked pictures of herself?
No, she sends me photos. They're not naked,
though. Do you send her pictures, naked pictures?
No, I don't.
Keep the apples, the guy said. So I'm back. Stephen Brody Stevens here with Esther and Brian. Little Brian and Esther.
I can't believe that you grabbed my dog like that.
Esther, you didn't.
Dog just wants a taste.
Did you show up
That's
for
disgusting.
Ice?
Disgusting. You're disgusting.
Esther, did you show up for Ice House Chronicles on the other night?
I didn't. I got sick.
What kind of sick?
I ate something gross and
food poisoning?
Something like that.
Chipotle?
Blowing out both ends?
No. Well, I don't want to get graphic, but it was graphic.
You guys would be proud of me. I've taken. I've done a number two at Coffee Bean recently.
Ooh, that's cool.
I do a number two wherever I am, whenever I need to.
I mean, I had to go, and I went, and, you know, I didn't have my baby wipes. I mean, they're out in my car.
Sandy brings them wherever he goes.
Well, he brings them in his car, and he just didn't have them in it.
I mean, I had mine in my car, but I was parked far away, and I said, I'll just use regular toilet paper. But I'll tell you what, I itched all day. I went hiking, and my ass was itching. I've, like, conditioned my
butthole.
Anal lips.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
To be.
Oh my god.
They've gotten so used to baby wipes that if you use toilet paper on it, irritates it. It itches.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay, well,
it's
I'm just sick of being accused of being immature for having a stuffed animal, for having baby food. When all this time you guys used baby wipes on your butt.
Yeah, but then everyone uses baby wipes unless you're...
Well, buy adult wipes, okay?
Well, that's what we're talking about. We're talking about...
Adult baby wipes.
Adult baby wipes.
Well...
Because we're...
I mean, there is a baby on the packaging.
So I'm not the only child here.
You think I'm a child for using baby wipes?
No, I guess that's what men do.
Does your butthole grow the older you get?
Okay.
Like, is there a certain cutoff size where you're like, no, that's the same size butthole you're always going to have?
Okay.
I don't quite understand the question, but I like to keep it clean, positive energy.
I'm gonna pass on this question.
I have a new thing that I like to do. If I had a fogo de chao poop once, and and it was like one of those ones where we usually take
a
photo.
You're a grown man in a fucking Pikachu costume.
You take a photo of it, those kind of ones, but it was in a public toilet, so I threw money on it, like a dollar, and then because somebody would probably go like, I'm not gonna flush this dollar, I'm gonna try to grab this dollar out. And then when they grab it and they go, holy shit, look how nice that turd is, you know.
That's kind of gross.
You're really gross. I don't want to be in your presence right now.
I don't think I'm trying to think if I ever grabbed crap.
No, I haven't. I once went to pick up dog poop with a wipey, mm-hmm. and my cousin smashed my hand into it.
What a good girl.
And it was a guy.
Oh, he says, what a good guy.
I have a really bad family.
You ever picked a booger and it had a comb over?
What does that mean?
A little hair attached?
No, but I pick boogers that have like dried blood and stuff.
Oh, good. You have dried blood?
Yeah, my nose this week I do.
Is that related to the food poisoning?
I don't think so.
How has your diet been? Where have you been eating?
Today I had Chipotle and ice cream. I don't know. It's been all over the place.
What kind of ice cream? Thrifties?
Actually, no. It was an ice cream. It was Froyo at Munchies.
Froyo's? Munchies?
Froyo at Munchies.
Frozen yogurt?
Yeah.
At Munchies?
Yeah.
Gotcha. Which Munchies?
I was in the Valley today.
The one on Laurel Canyon?
That may have been where it was.
You don't want to say?
I don't want to give the exclusive info out too soon.
I'm moving near that area.
Oh, near Munchies, eh?
Near Munchies.
Wait, in North Hollywood area?
That area.
Oh, I know exactly where that is. That's by me.
You're in Burbank.
Yeah, North Hollywood's right next door.
Right, I'm not that far.
You know what? I like the Valley. Maybe I'll move. Is there an open place in your place?
There's tons of places in North Hollywood.
I'm moving back essentially a quarter mile west of my last apartment where I had my manic episode. I'm going back home, and I like it. It's more getting out of Hollywood than going back home. It's more like number one, I wanted to, yeah, it's getting out of Hollywood and going back home, because I could have moved somewhere else, like maybe up to Silver Lake or Beechwood Canyon or West Hollywood. And I felt like that would be two difficulties. One, moving, and then two, going to a new part of the city. Like, at least this, I'm going back to where I know the neighborhood. It just feels good, like, to go back there. It's like, Esther.
What?
You really are upset that I'm moving.
Yeah. I don't want you to go. I don't want to be alone.
I'm going to miss seeing your car.
Yeah.
Though I don't see it as much lately.
That's not true. It was there all weekend.
Yeah, I like when it's there. I like to know that you're safe in our building.
Yeah.
You're upstairs. You're on your bed. You're interneting. You're there with Amy, who's a good friend of yours, good roommate. Mm-hmm. You guys have such a nice apartment. I'm really, really impressed with how you guys put it together, because I have the same layout. And you have two people living in an apartment.
Yeah.
And I'm one guy, and I couldn't handle it.
Yeah, it's, you know, she does a lot to, you know, keep that place in its good condition. Every time I put my clothes on the floor and then I leave, somehow they've been put away. I don't know if it's a magician or a tooth fairy or if it's her, but...
So you're living with a mom.
Yeah.
It's amazing how nice your apartment is.
Thank you. And that's all her. That's not me. That's my roommate.
But you guys are so clean.
Like I said, that's all her.
Yeah. Did you ever see her Esther's apartment when she placed it before?
Yeah, it was kind of messy.
Yeah.
I don't know if it was dirty. Was it?
Yeah, it was pretty.
Wasn't
gross.
Dirty? Was it?
Was like dog
it
poop been in her dirty. Bed.
That was the old one that he saw. The.
Did you clean your shower out a lot?
No.
You didn't before.
No.
But you don't track in dirt.
Maybe not.
I mean, you're a clean person. When I see you, I think of you as clean, like not dirty at all.
Thank you.
I don't think you walk outside barefoot.
No, not an unreasonable amount.
Your skin's good.
Thank you. I needed that.
Your hair seems nice and healthy.
It needs a cut. I needed an emergency haircut, actually.
You got a hair emergency.
Yeah, it's like, it's too long. I don't believe in haircuts. I think they're a scam. I don't want to get a cut. It's just going to grow back.
Have you shaved your chest lately?
I don't shave my chest.
Narrow your chest.
I don't narrow pluck my chest. I may pluck my chest once in a while when necessary.
Are you pretty groomed right now? Do you have hairy legs right now? Hairy armpits? Hairy everything?
Why is that information supposed to be publicized?
Because I just want to know if you're taking care of yourself.
I'm taking care of myself. I brush my teeth at night. I'm taking care of myself.
You brushing your teeth before you go to bed?
Yes, I am. I'm sick of my parents asking, and yeah, I do.
Are there nights when you don't or nights when you haven't?
No, I brush my teeth every night now.
No, you're saying now, but was there a time when you weren't?
Starting Saturday.
Was there a time when you weren't brushing your teeth?
Yeah, I got into some trouble.
Bad habits.
Yeah, and I went home for a dentist, and I had four cavities, and I got into trouble.
You developed four cavities from not brushing at night?
Yeah.
Wow, I'm afraid you know what? I've gone down that road.
Don't do it, because it's, especially your parents, if they find out, it's bad.
Well, my mom would find out.
Yeah, it was a really hard time for my family. And now every time I go to the dentist, it's like a big thing.
So you weren't brushing at night?
I don't want to get into the details, but sometimes I didn't. I just didn't care. I'm not inherently a clean person. I will let things go. I didn't care. I'm trying to care more and have a little more self-respect, as my parents put it.
I need to brush my teeth more. Brian, do you brush your teeth every night before you go to bed?
This should be good.
Fuck.
This should be real good.
Now, I wouldn't say every night. There's definitely nights that like I'll pass out.
You
or if I'm at a girl's house, you know, and I crashed at her house, you know, I'm not going to brush my teeth. But the first thing I did the next morning is I run home and brush my teeth, you know, and I'm disgusted by it. But
I wouldn't stay over someplace if I didn't have a toothbrush.
I feel I have a bunch of cavities.
You should get a dentist.
Well, I feel I have them because this medication I've been on, hate to bring that up, and then also not brushing at night due to depression. You know, I do brush my teeth every day. I get up and I brush my teeth. But there's times when I haven't brushed them at night, going through this recent period of my life. And I admit to that.
Thank you.
You know, Esther, I feel comfortable being open with you.
Thank you. That means a lot to me.
Because you're smart. I look up to you.
Thank you. I look up to you.
I think your Twitter is great.
Thank you.
I think...
Little Esther.
Little Esther, you put out...
Esther Monster on Instagram.
And I like it's Esther Monster. You're a big fan of Lady Gaga. You seem to be happy. You're doing your spots. You're okay?
I mean, you know, I ate a lot today, so I'm working through that.
But now, was it because you were stressed out by this audition?
I think it was just an overall stress.
Overall...
I don't smoke, I don't drink, I don't do drugs. I get joy from eating. And so I really went to Chipotle. I was like, I'm going to make a healthy choice. And then for some reason, I made an unhealthy choice.
Were you...
I got extra cheese and extra sour cream.
Oh, my God.
I know.
Esther.
I know.
Extra cheese, extra sour cream. I've never done that.
I ate the whole thing. I ate it quick. I ate it alone. It was a little dark.
It was getting dark out?
Well, no, I was in the restaurant, but no, it was in the day. It just felt dark. There was a dark tone.
How was your audition?
It was fine.
How was your day before the audition? You remember?
It's all a haze.
So you said you weren't having a good day, or you were?
I can't remember.
Overwhelmed.
I can't remember anything before the burrito, to be honest.
So the burrito really shook your axis.
Yeah. But I've done that before. I behave like that. It's like that's my self-destructive behavior.
Where did you get ice cream?
I told you I got it at Menchie's.
Okay, my bad.
That's okay.
But that's not ice cream. That's frozen yogurt. And you did say frozen yogurt.
It is, but I get a lot of really, again, destructive toppings. I go hard. I go.
So bad. Why were you doing this?
I don't know. Self-sabotage.
Meaning like
boredom.
It's going to make you feel bad later, or it's going to make you gain weight, or it's going to make you feel upset
maybe
that you allowed yourself to do that.
I was feeling deprived maybe. I don't know. I just needed it.
It's okay to have comfort food. Was this beyond comfort food?
Maybe not. But I did. I exercised afterwards. And
great.
It made me feel better. But it still doesn't undo the damage.
But it's not that bad going to Chipotle. The
no,
extra
it's not.
Sour cream and extra
all
cheese.
The time.
Extra.
Yeah.
I stopped going to Chipotle because it kind of stays with me the rest of the day. It's like you're always belching Chipotle.
I don't know.
It's
that
pretty
problem.
Heavy. It could be heavy.
Yeah, it was a little heavy today.
That's why I've been going to Zanku.
I love Zanku.
I'm not into that place at all.
What? I think you're probably just getting the wrong thing. Because, I mean, you could get the wrong thing at Zanku and you'd be like, meh.
Oh, it's good food.
Yeah. What do you get, 11 or 12 or whatever, the one that's all?
Yeah, I get the chicken plate, yeah. Or I'll get a chicken sandwich, chicken tarna sandwich, I think it's what it's called, and the get the beef tri-tip, get that. It's good. And I know, I mean, I'm sure it's, it seems healthy. I mean, I see people that are in exercise outfit and in good shape eating there. Is it good for you?
It's not the best, but it's chicken.
Yeah, it's chicken. It's protein.
Yeah. I mean, I eat it. I don't when I eat it, I don't really feel like I'm eating bad too much.
Yeah, I love the hummus.
I like that garlic the other stuff though.
I don't know. I don't know. I just have had bad experiences.
You've had bad experiences there?
Yeah, I'd rather have Chick-fil-A.
There's bad locations.
Oh my God. I wouldn't go public with that.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I will say this.
Your people hate Chick-fil-A, don't they, Brody?
Well, Chick-fil-A, actually, from what I hear, I've been told by some cool people, they said that Chick-fil-A kind of backtracked, or they said some other things. So
I just don't think that my chicken sandwich purchase can hurt a gay person. I think all companies fund things privately that we don't know about, and I'm not going to – I don't know. I feel like it's okay. What are they trying to do? They're not like making a system to kill gay people. They're just like funding a church. That church can't do anything to anybody, right? I don't know. I hate churches, so.
You hate church?
Yeah.
You hate religion?
I guess I don't hate. I'm opposed to religion.
It gives people some strength. I pray to God.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I was going through some rough times. I know people don't like to hear about it, and I did smoke pot before this podcast, and I probably shouldn't have, but I'm getting sobering up right now. You know, there's real pressures involved, but it's like doing a show like this has been great, and people go, don't talk about it anymore. I still have to talk about it, and I'll have fun with it. Just like I had a great time on Ice House Chronicles the other night. I was able to act and have a fun time. You know, Brian's a great, you know, it's great seeing Brian out at the comedy store, supporting live comedy, hanging out, not complaining, I should be getting up there, I'm funnier than this guy. Doesn't do that. There's a lot of guys who go to the comedy store who could be on the stage, and you do hear them complain, I'm funnier than that guy. Brian doesn't do that. He comes there, he supports, he'll wear my t-shirt, he brings positive energy. And that's impressive. That's the stuff that's going on. You know, Brian's putting out the energy. I'm dedicated to it. Esther, putting out the energy, doing the auditions, going to Chipotle, going to Menchie's. And you exercise after, though.
Yeah, but that doesn't help as much. It helps mentally, but physically it's not.
It got you back to square one.
It did bring me back to earth, you know. That was good.
How, you went to the gym?
No, I take dance classes.
Do you get a good sweat in those?
No.
You don't? Is it a lot of stretching?
There's some stretching.
Is there cardio?
No.
Wow.
I don't like cardio because I don't...
Do you...
My boobs hurt from cardio.
Does it build up your legs?
No, I don't know.
Esther, what is going on with you? This is a side that I'm not used to seeing.
I want a caramel apple.
Esther, you had ice cream from Menchie's today. Froyo.
It was like 5 hours ago.
You want to see a picture of my dick?
No. Hey, come on. Red band. Brian, don't do that. Keep it positive.
I want to go home.
No, Esther, stop it. Tell Sprinkles to relax.
Sprinkles want to sit on Pikachu's lap?
You're a disgusting pervert, okay? You're a disgusting pervert. I'm an adult. I don't need this.
You're very protective of Sprinkles.
Yeah, I'm a good mother.
You are.
This is how you do it.
You're going to be a good mother. You ever think about that, Esther? You're texting right now.
No, I...
Are you tweeting or texting? And you can. You're allowed to do that.
I will probably... I don't know. I'm not going to have... I'll have kids in like 20 years.
So do you get a lot of at replies on Twitter?
Maybe. Some.
Maybe. Some. A little bit of an attitude tonight.
No, that's not true.
You must be really upset that I'm leaving and this is kind of some passive-aggressive behavior.
It's true.
Did you have a spot last night at the comedy store? Or, I mean, on Saturday night?
Yeah.
Did you do it?
Uh-huh.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I went late after my party.
You went late?
Well, I had a full night, and then I went after my night. And I was wearing my Kardashian jumpsuit.
Your spot was at, like, 9:30, wasn't it? Or no, 10:30?
No, it was at, like, midnight. It was, like, 11:30.
Was it fun?
It was really fun.
How was the audience? How many people were in there?
I don't know, like 40, 50.
Do you get nervous when you play a packed OR?
I think we talked about this last time.
Oh, I'm sorry. My memory's not the greatest.
That's okay. That's what I'm here for.
Who's to say that somebody listening to the podcast tonight didn't listen to last week?
Well, then they're not a good fan. I'm just kidding. That's okay.
All right, I'll never bring it up again.
That's okay, Brody. You can. I'm sorry. This is a lot to deal with that you're leaving the building. I don't know how to handle it. I'm just really stressed out. I don't want to be alone. Okay, this is disgusting. Something really awful just happened.
Brian, did you text a disgusting photo to Esther?
I'm not looking at it. I'm not acknowledging it any further.
Did you send a penis picture to Esther?
No, I sent you that, though.
Let me see. Oh, I mean, I'm not 10% gay.
No, I didn't. I didn't send it. I sent her a picture, but it wasn't my penis. Well, why don't you tell him what it was? Esther, so people.
No.
So, Brian, when you go on Twitter, you get a lot of at replies when you post stuff?
Yeah.
You read them all?
I read all my tweets.
Do you reply back to as many as you can or none?
No,
or
I don't.
All?
I don't really reply at all. I'll retweet somebody. Like if somebody says something positive, I'm like, oh, thanks. You know, instead of saying thanks, I'll just retweet it. I shouldn't do that, but I just don't like how RTs look. Also, you know, like when you RT and then write something else after.
Right.
I like just regular retweeting.
You're stylized. I like it.
I like it because then people are like, oh, who's this person that said this? You know, so it's kind of like advertising for the people instead of, I don't know.
Joe Wagner goes, this is the most fucked up episode of To Catch a Predator I've ever seen. I get chicks with dicks. Thanks.
Yes.
Thanks, Joe.
Taste it.
No, I didn't taste anything. But it's therapeutic for me. Like I said, I'll perform. We had a good time last night in the main room. What did you think about that show?
It was cool. I mean, it was stressful, but it was kind of fun watching Earl and you. Like, you were performing with a ladder on stage at one point, and it was really cool seeing you fucking still getting laughs while there was all these obstacles on stage. There was some technical problems with the projector, so Brody was, you know, thrown on stage during.
They asked me, and again, last night I did, I'm not supposed to, but I did smoke pot, and I apologize, and I have to be open about this. I am on medication. I know you don't want to hear it, but I have to let you know so you can check up on me. I'm at 200 milligrams of Lamictal. I'm on 30 milligrams of Lexapro. I'm on 20 milligrams of Latuda, and I take Klonopin when needed. I'm weaning myself off these meds. They do help me feel better. They make my comedy better. And I'm developing structure in my life. And doing a podcast like this helps me out. Doing comedy last night in the main room, when you see Brian there putting out that energy, showing up, he could easily go home. He could easily go to Burbank. He could easily go hang out with a hot chick. But he says, I want to hang out at the Comedy Store. And that's what he does.
What is this? Are you reading?
No, I'm just talking.
Oh,
I thought you were reading something. I was like, how did he get those that tweet so long? Like, I was thinking it was somebody tweeting.
Are we wrapping it up?
No. Why? Why are you saying that, Esther?
I think it's time.
Are you serious?
It's been an hour and a half.
Oh.
What, Brody?
I mean, I could go all night.
Is that what you tell them, boy? I mean,
well,
ladies?
I need a bathroom break.
We can wrap it up.
Do the dollar bill trick that I taught you.
I don't do.
I'm not gonna put a dollar bill in a toilet. First of all, because I need my dollars. Second of all, I don't have dollars. I use a credit card, no cash. Third of all.
Yeah, I'm sure this Chipotle bathroom break is gonna be.
No, it's not. I just have to pee.
You know, there's all different kind of podcasts out there. This one, what you witnessed tonight, is. Brody and Esther, neighbors.
Not anymore.
She's upset with it. You can't replicate that energy.
Oh, my God.
She just slammed the door. Oh, my God.
What the fuck was that all about?
That is true anger.
Would you dare me to smell the seat that she was just sitting on?
I mean, you probably would, Brian.
Would you?
No, I'm not. I don't look at Esther that way.
Why don't you look at her that way? I mean, you had the opportunity to start a pretty good thing, because it was like a booty call thing in your own building. So like you could have gone like, hey, what are you doing? You laying in bed by yourself? Want to come up here with Broadster?
I don't think that was going to happen. I mean, I've dated comedian girls before. I've been with a couple, few. That may happen again, but I'm so like focused on my career right now. And I don't know if that's a healthy thing or an unhealthy thing, but girls can approach me. I'm okay with that. Send me that email. Come up to me after a show. You know, I need to be attracted to you. There's an attractive woman who approached me a couple weeks ago in Irvine, and I followed up on that. And we're supposed to meet in Santa Monica and maybe go for a run on the beach or a walk. So I'm looking forward to that. Esther's very, you know, it's like...
Look at this, Esther.
Oh, my God. Look away, Sprinkles. That's awful. That's violent.
Your friend sent that. Nick Spears.
Nick Spears. I know him. Nick, he's funny.
Yeah.
Nick.
Do you know Nick Spears, Esther? Yeah. How do you know him?
Just through, like, I think through Crystalia and through Twitter. He's so, Nick Spears is so funny.
So funny. I love, I don't want to give his joke away, but never mind.
Well, I'm a little upset, though, what he just tweeted, but.
Where does he live?
I think he lives by Irvine, doesn't he? Close to Irvine.
How did, you mean, what do you mean Crystalia and him? How did you meet him through Chris?
I can't remember.
They're friends?
Through Twitter.
When you hooked up with Chris D'Elia...
I've never hooked up with Chris D'Elia. He hooks up with hot chicks, okay? He's just my friend. I know him because I know someone that he dated. And through comedy.
Do you think a lot of comedians would exchange lives with Chris D'Elia?
I don't know. I'm not... I don't... I have no idea.
He's living a great life. He's confident. He's comfortable. He's funny. He's good looking. I have nothing bad to say. It's like, what can I say that's bad? You know... I want to find something bad. Yes.
Well, you can find stuff. There's a lot going around.
But that's just my negative energy.
No, I'm not getting negative about anything. Keep it positive.
I'm not being negative. I like Chris.
So
I'm just saying
he's
that
one of my friends.
It seems like a lot of people are out to get that guy because
they are
a little success in him.
The people do that with everybody. Who's
I don't think they do it with Zach Galifianakis so much or Will Ferrell or you talking about new success too. Esther, you started to stop with the animals. Esther, this is a podcast. Thousands of people are listening, and you're hugging a stuffed animal. Oh, you're playing to the cameras. Good.
You guys both like to play to the cameras.
I do sometimes. I'm too hard on myself. But it's like being around here, doing the great stuff. So, Esther...
Yeah.
What is wrong with you tonight? I drove all the way out here for Pasadena.
So did I. There's nothing wrong. We've been having a great podcast. What should we talk about?
I get it. I understand. I could keep going.
I just...
You've petered out.
You've been taking breaks. I haven't been taking breaks.
Oh, then I'll talk. Okay.
Go ahead.
I'm feeling great about myself. I went hiking today. I have a new apartment. I picked up the keys. I can actually move stuff in tonight.
You think you're going to do that? You think you're going to take maybe a box over and just sit there on the
this.
Floor?
I can.
I don't want to
I would.
Hear this.
Because I think getting a new place is exciting. I mean, have you called the...
I'm excited.
Called the utility places yet and all that stuff?
I need to do that tomorrow, right? Given the dates.
Right.
I need to... I'm still going to have to pay rent for where I'm at, but I'm going to give them a, you know... I'm going to take a loss on that, but... I don't care. I just want to like move out on my own speed, get a couch, get a bed, get my cable over there. I could survive for a year. If you said, Brody, you're not going to work anymore, I could survive, probably pay my rent and survive for a year. But I want to keep working. I want to keep feeling good. It's been like 5 consecutive days without crying. You know, I couldn't talk to my mom without crying. But I'm on 200 milligrams of Lamictal. Remember, I had I haven't spoken about it. I had a manic episode. So, like, sometimes I can still get stressed or mania, and I'm sure the pot doesn't help. So I want to be open with you guys and go, you know what? I smoked a little pot before. I probably shouldn't have. I look high, you know?
You do look pretty high. Your eyes look really high.
I know, they do, and I apologize for that. It's unprofessional. But I wouldn't show up doing warm-up high. I wouldn't show up doing stand-up at a club high like this, and I disrespected this podcast forum. But you know what? Podcasts are so real, and it's just talking. I can get away with it. And it's not getting away with it. I can kind of like be open about it. And it's okay because this isn't a performance. This is just you guys listening to me, Esther, and Brian talk, you know, goof around, you know. And if for me, I like it. You know, you get to see a little bit what I do. And then it's like also good that I have that female energy that I can interact with. Esther's a good, good source of that. And she's funny, you know. Imagine if she was unfunny and I was doing the show. I'm doing a podcast with a girl who's funny. There's a lot of funny girls out there.
There's a lot of shows that have unfunny girls on them. And
yeah.
And people can sniff that shit out, you know, immediately.
But Esther's got things going on. There's a cool factor. I see it, you know. And so I need to be somehow linked or connected to it. I'm on the Esther bandwagon. It's a good decision. And then you got Brian, positive energy, doing shows, t-shirt, supportive there at the Comedy Store, putting the time in, doing these podcasts, doing stand-up, making cool flyers, becoming a better stand-up as he's doing stand-up, becoming a better podcaster. What do you think about that?
Do you want to watch another podcast while we're podcasting?
Nancy's dad.
She has
up.
What I call cummy teeth.
She did in England. That's
yeah. Is that on live right now?
Yeah.
I put the fluoride all over her mouth.
Why yeah, are you putting
dude,
this
that's on? What that, just well, first week that, you know, Naughty Show's been on their own. First episode. Really? The girls have, they're against us in ratings now.
So the
why
joint
are we
studios?
Showing them if they're against us on ratings?
Because let's look at the numbers here. We got 40 people watching that.
This is funny that Brian's doing this.
But he's advertising.
It's kind of cool.
It is cool. I'm helping the guys out, I'm letting people know. And
you're advertising for them by
210. So we're doing good.
210 are watching live.
Yeah. Wow. Look at that.
And how many will? How many will at the when all is said and done? How many will be tallied up from this podcast? How many ears?
Video. I would probably say not. Video is not much, but I would probably say like. Including YouTubes and Ustreams and Vimeos, I'd probably say maybe like 15,000 to 20,000 people will see this episode for video.
Right.
Audio, I'm just going to say ballpark. Like Death Squad averagely gets about 60,000 downloads a day on average. You know, some episodes get hundreds of thousands. You know, this one will probably get about anywhere from, you know, 50 to 75,000.
This will?
Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Death Squad's, I mean, is that, you and you built this from scratch.
Mm-hmm.
Got to feel good about that.
Well, without the help of Joe Rogan, you know, it probably wouldn't be as successful. But yeah, it's the
and
help.
The inspiration and, of Little Esther.
Yeah. Well, that's the cool thing about Death Squad is like, I didn't really build it. I just put all the shit together and it's mostly you guys, you know, you fucking all the different shows we have on here. Brody, Sam Tripoli, you know, Tom Segura.
Is Sam Tripoli still going to be on here?
No. He'll probably be on some Ice House Chronicles here and there and stuff, but he just wanted to reboot Naughty Show because, I don't know, I think he was just kind of not getting, you know, the kind of feedback he wanted I think he was just getting frustrated with not blowing up. You know, I mean, he was almost on his 100th episode here at Death Squad. And I think maybe within the last 20 episodes, I don't know, or so, it just kind of seems like it was just kind of getting stale. I even felt it, you know, and it just, I think what he wants to know is if he can try to reboot it and do something with it, make it go to the next level,
right?
You know? And I think it's exactly what he needed to do. And I mean, it's sad because I liked doing Naughty Show every week, but I totally understand it. You know, like I get it.
Right.
Right. So watch him.
You advertise for him?
Yeah, I've said.
Oh, by putting him on the show tonight here.
Yeah, I've showed that's on right now. Yeah.
So let me gather my thoughts because I did. I am. That was a great speech, Brian, about Naughty Show. I'm happy. I'm doing. I had a great time last night performing. I like the podcasts. Oh, Ice House Chronicles. That's what I want to ask about. How popular are those? You don't have to give out numbers. I mean, whatever you feel comfortable with. But are Ice House Chronicles? Or is that its own little show in itself?
Yeah. The Ice House Chronicles is probably the biggest show on Death Squad.
Really?
Yeah.
How was it on Friday?
It was horrible.
Why?
I mean, the podcast I thought was good. I thought the podcast was good. At the beginning was like a big Brody episode at the beginning.
I was just trying to do, whenever you have Don Barris involved, you know, there's going to be some type of, depending what Don you get.
Yeah.
Right.
So we got the Don that wanted to joke around and go and like interrupt a little bit.
Yeah. And
which is fine. That's what Don likes to do. We have a good time with that. But go ahead, Brian.
Yeah, and I thought, you know, the second half was good. We played a game. You weren't there, but you did a good prank to all of us. You know, I don't want to spoil the prank, but you did a pretty decent prank, and it fooled all of us, and all of us, like, I almost turned off the whole entire show.
Right. So, yeah, listen to the show And it's one of the funnier podcasts I've been involved with in a long time. It made me feel good. The camaraderie made me feel good. I like doing Ice House Chronicles. My only thing is a lot of times I have a spot at the Comedy Store. And so I'll do the podcast. Then I run in and do the show. And then I race to the Comedy Store. It's like I do Ice House Chronicles all night, a 24-hour Ice House Chronicles, or till the sun comes up for charity or something like that, or, you know, something like that. I like doing Ice House Chronicles. I know also being on this network, you get the fans, the Death Squad fans, they are loyal. I get a lot of tweets.
I love Death Squad.
They're great, you know?
I'm the Death Squad queen. Someone said I was the princess. I think I'm the queen.
Yeah.
Honey Boo Boo.
Esther, have you ever been a squirter?
Oh, Brian, I've been on such a positive roll, and you come with that.
No.
Would you want to be if you had the option?
No, and it's pee.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. Mm-mm. Yes, it is.
You're saying it does not come out of your cum?
It's pee.
It does not come
out
of your
fluid?
Pee. You know those little, when you go to Starbucks, those things you put in your coffee when you drive, like those little green things that you put in there? You break a little off, put it in your pee hole. I'll make you squirt, and you'll realize that thing's still going to be in your pee hole.
It doesn't.
Well, Brian,
done. That's it.
No.
We're
Esther,
done.
Stop it.
I'm done.
Esther, no, please. I'm addicted to podcasting. Please, over no circumstances.
This show has been over for 20 minutes. We're done.
I did some of my best material this past 20 minutes. I get real.
I would like some candy.
Yes.
You know what? I've been...
It's not one of those shows. I don't do it on this show.
Brian, you don't have candy?
I don't.
It's Halloween, okay?
It's I have all. If I have any candy, it has weed in it.
Well, no, I can't do that. I'm a kid.
So, Esther.
There's a banana over there.
Ew. It's probably...
Brand new. Ari brought it.
I don't trust it.
Would you trust a banana from Ari, Brody?
I don't trust any produce that Ari's I didn't buy myself. It says nothing to do with Ari. It's just I don't want a random banana. I don't know where he got it.
Random banana.
I don't want a banana from 7-Eleven. I want a banana.
Why not? They look good.
I don't
just
really,
wash them off.
I also don't really.
Wash off the peel.
I'm not into bananas.
I eat, one banana a day. Usually at Coffee Bean, I'll get a banana. I get a Raisin Bran muffin I get a large coffee with. I do put a little half and half and a little Splenda. I know I shouldn't be doing that, and it says something about me. I'm getting comfortable. So I get a large iced coffee with an extra shot and a Raisin Bran muffin. Then I sit down, and I'll see Kirk Fox, or I'll see Nuzzy from the Decently Funny podcast. I'll see... some hot chicks. Oh my God. The girls now, they show their ass cheeks. That's the new style. Yeah. Like the lower ass cheeks.
A bunch of ass showing lately, I noticed.
Oh my God. I mean, that's the greatest thing. I perch. I get this one chair that's usually open, and it's right there at Coffee Bean. I see every girl that's in line. It's like, I know my libido's back.
I'm not supporting this conversation.
Why?
Even though I check out hot girls. I get it. This seems...
And that's how I know I'm not gay. Also, it's like I'm sitting there looking at hot girls. And you know how many gay guys come through there with good bodies and cool muscles and stuff?
You're not gay.
Cool muscles.
Cool muscles. I'm not into that. I see these chicks with the lower ass cheek hanging out. It's like, great. I mean, I just want to squeeze it, you know, but I'm under control. So I sit there. I get my Bran muffin. And then I get a refill. You can get as many refills as you want. Did you know that? All day. Some people use the same cup like all week.
Yeah, homeless people.
I've thought about doing it. But I'm pretty honorable. You know, I play by the rules usually. But I'll get a refill and then I do a banana. And I know I'm paying extra for the banana. It's like 95 cents. And I know I could probably make coffee at home. But for me, just the idea of getting out of the house and investing in myself by going to this Coffee Bean... makes a difference for me. I can't isolate. And it's part of it. There's the podcasting, like doing a podcast, just being open, doing my own, doing this, being a guest.
You know, I'm going to share something.
Oh, go ahead, Esther. I'm sharing, and I'd like you to... don't
I'm
be
sorry.
Sorry
to interrupt. It's relevant to the hurricane situation. I have a friend who is from New York. He's home visiting his family in New York. And he texted me that, you know, if he's scared, you know, whatever, it's not good. Electricity's out. And I'm like, I'm so sorry. I hope you're safe. I miss you. And then he said, my dad's boat is destroyed. I feel really bad. And I was like, okay, I'm sorry. And then he went on about this boat and how it's $300,000. And I was like, LOL.
Wait, you said LOL?
Yeah. And he was like, what are you talking about? This is really serious. And I was like, look, bro, my parents barely own a house that's barely worth $300,000. I don't give a fuck about your dad's $300,000 boat.
That has Are you probably, serious, that probably Esther? Has ins- that probably yeah. has insurance, and he, you know.
Yeah, I don't care. It's so.
I see what you're saying. It's like, wait, you're bragging about a $300,000.
Yeah, I get it. Like, that's awful for your personal things to be destroyed. I understand. I'm concerned with your safety. But if you're going to complain about your already privileged life, and what you said is correct. I'm sure it has insurance. It's like, stop being a baby and trying to get attention from me. I understand what's happening is very terrible, and I'm very concerned for safety. And if my home was destroyed, I would obviously be very upset. But I can't identify with the overly wealthy. I'm the 1%. I don't understand, and I don't like it when people are upset with me that I can't understand it. Because if I wouldn't pay $10 for a boat that was worth $300,000.
Why not? That's a good deal.
That is a good deal, and that does strike me as interesting. But I just can't. I don't spend that way. I've never lived that way. I respect. I actually don't. I guess I don't.
Maybe he had great memories on that $300,000 boat.
Yeah, but it's like, get over yourself. I don't care.
But do you think it's a little too soon to be harsh on the guy when he's dealing with a hurricane?
Maybe it's just because it's someone that's like always like. They're from money, and it's like always a big forefront issue that I can't empathize.
You can't see my balls under the table right now.
Brian, no. Please. I'm trying to do a straight edge podcast here. But Esther, don't you think that this guy who's in the eye of the hurricane, this Frankenstorm, and you're going to do an LOL line, no matter how you, whether that's legitimate or not, I just think the timing is kind of harsh. What do you think about that? Go ahead, Esther.
What was the question?
Regarding the LOL line, I feel that your friend, if he is, he's a friend or an acquaintance, is going through a lot right now, going through Hurricane Sandy. And maybe...
I'm sorry that you're a rich parents' boat is hurting. I'm so sorry.
But you...
I feel so bad for you. Will you be okay that your boat is gone? Are you going to make it through the year without your boat?
But you're not even thinking about his safety.
I am. That's you the thing are? Is that I am thinking about his safety. I'm like, I hope you're safe.
You
I
threw care. That in.
I did. I said, I'll read the... You know what? I'm going to pull it up and I'm going to read what I said.
Okay.
As evidence for this situation. I said... He said, I miss you, because he's just my friend. And I said, same, LOL.
So he's getting service.
And then he said, I just told you my dad's boat might be gone. That's pretty fucking bad. $300,000 boat. Which, by the way, that's information that doesn't need to be in there. And I said, can't identify with that at all. Sorry. My parents barely own a house that's worth less than that. Sorry, bro. Just hope you're safe.
That's still kind of, I was barely listening, and that is still kind of harsh.
Brian, what do you think?
Brian has compassion. He wasn't listening either.
Pictures of my balls.
He wasn't listening. I listened.
I think I see. I know what she's saying. I probably wouldn't have said that. Obviously, I'd probably have just been like, just ignored that. I thought, but yeah, I totally understand what she's saying. But yeah, it's probably not what I would have said.
She's texting him back right now, I think.
No, I'm not. I'm texting someone else.
Should I send in the picture of my balls to her?
I mean, you can. There's nothing. I mean, I would say no. Don't do that. But it's totally your call. And I know you two have this kind of relationship where you've probably sent pictures of your balls to Esther before, and she's seen them and she laughed and all that stuff.
I've never done it before. All right, I sent it to her.
But
she's not paying attention anyway, so she doesn't know.
I'm feeling pretty good. I think the pot I got to be careful with. I took two hits. Maybe I should have just done one or none. And I don't keep it in my house. Here's the deal. If you see me buy pot, if I have pot on me, take it from me. Ask me. Say, Brody, do you have pot? And make me hand it over to you. I don't need to have it on me. Now, to go to a party or go to a writing session or a podcast, maybe I'll take a baby hit. But even a podcast, that's disrespectful because you're hearing my voice and it gets dry and all that. But I definitely cannot smoke pot before a performance. Don't you dare let me, remind me, tweet me. I'm admitting I have a problem, but you know what? Death Squad can help me get through this with therapy. Twitter can help me get through this. Invest in me. Or you can say, you know what, Brody? Get tough and do it on your own. But look at my life. Look at my life. I had a repressed childhood. I didn't go to prom. I think I'm 10% gay.
Okay. I'm going to just get in here right now.
What?
We're moving on from the prom thing. It's been 25 years. We're over it. And you're not 10% gay. We discovered that on this episode.
But maybe there was a reason why I felt that way. There's a reason. Okay. I'm saying, for the sake of this right now, I'm not 10% gay. But the fact that I thought I was 10% gay is what was bothering me.
Did you get my picture, Esther?
I didn't look at it.
Just look at it. It's not gross. It's a joke picture.
I'm not looking at anything you send me anymore because it's gross always.
Brian, let me ask a question.
It's abusive. This is sexual abuse. You know?
Brian, have you been able to get special treatment let's say I wanted to get a facial. Are there any Death Squad...
Wait, you mean being cummed on your face?
No! Yeah, Brian! That is completely...
Is that what you're talking about? That's what a facial is.
A completely uncomfortable and all uncalled for on the day I signed my lease to move into my one-bedroom apartment. No, but... you know they have Kickstarter for things? Like, look, I'm going to do this and mm-hmm. you're going to raise money for this. Are there things like on Amazon or are there services that...
I would love a rip your float.
Is there anyone here that listens to this podcast who can get me a membership to 24 Hour Fitness?
I couldn't. I had to buy my own.
You did?
But I mean, you could just put it out there and see if somebody help you out.
But people are buying my t-shirts. You know, it's good. Like my friends are buying my t-shirts. It's a way of helping me out.
Yeah, and then we're going to get those shirts. BrodyStevens.BigCartel.com.
Yeah, we're going to... I think the URL is going to be changed to www.brodymerch.com. Brodymerch.com. But right now, for the time being, it is www.brodystevens, B-R-O-D-Y, Stevens, .bigcartel.com. And there I have two t-shirts. I have a red Enjoy It Brody. It's actually Brody in a Coca-Cola script, and it's red.
I love it.
With
That's
white.
The one I got.
People really like it. Then I have a baseball, softball tee one. My face is on it. A lot of people say don't put your face on things, but it's kind of just a caricature. Well, it's actually my face. It's not a caricature, but it's a photo. And it says Stephen Brody Stevens, and on the back it says 818 Enjoy It, and people are buying those too. They're both selling at equal amount of veracity. Is that the word? But equal amount. And we have some new colors coming out. I think we're going to go with brown. Is getting a lot of feedback. It's brown or black with the Brody Coca-Cola sign. So that's my merchandise. It's been a great first 3 weeks, and we just want to keep it going. It really helps. If you buy my t-shirts, you wear them, you promote, it's going to help me. It's going to help me get on the road. It's going to help me survive in life. You know, I'm probably not going to be in Hangover 3. I haven't got the call. I don't expect. I got 2 more weeks maybe, and that's it. And if it hasn't happened by now, I don't think it's going to happen. And I'm going to have to deal with that.
Did you ask Zach?
I've speak to Zach. I'm sure. What did he say? He said he's you know, talking to people and trying, you know, but there's no guarantees. This is Hollywood. This is real business. This is real life. I'm thankful that I got Hangover 1 and Hangover 2. I'll take it at that. But when The Hangover 3 comes along, I won't be going to the premiere. There's no way I can do that. And hopefully it won't be a stressor.
I recently did a podcast with Brie Olson.
Yes.
That can be found on iTunes or weirdadults.com.
Thank you. Brie Olson was with Charlie Sheen?
Yeah.
Was he abusive towards her, or is that what happened, or she was abusive towards him, or what happened?
I don't know.
You didn't ask that question on your podcast?
You're playing it coy. I don't know right now.
You're playing it coy.
We'll save it for the Death Squad special edition.
Mm.
Yeah, Look at Esther with the edgy attitude tonight. I kind of like it.
Wow.
Yeah, I'm good. I can't wait to, like, I'm going to get my own apartment, and I'm gonna get off that air mattress, and I'm going to start getting chicks. I can't wait. I wonder who the first girl I'm going to bed is going to be, you know?
If you ever want to go out, and just skip a night of comedy and just, hit the town and try to pick up some snuff,
Snuff? We can just go to 7-Eleven.
Some pooch.
Put a pooch.
What's it called the kids call it nowadays?
Some
gashes.
Brian. Some nice girls.
Some good girls.
Some women.
Maybe we can hit K-Town and go to like a nightclub.
That's a far drive. Maybe somewhere in the valley.
Yeah.
Even Burbank.
Yeah, we can maybe hit Sardo's tomorrow night for porn karaoke.
Yeah. Porn chicks would like me. That's the other thing. Like, spread my T-shirt. Spread my, it's like, if I have sex, I'll tell you about it. That's what I'm going to be completely honest with you. If I have sex, I will share those details on a Death Squad podcast.
That boy is a monster, monster. He ate my heart. We should probably wrap up.
It's been 2 hours.
I knew the Lady Gaga would seal the deal for the death of this episode.
I thought it was a good podcast.
I think it was
I could
great.
Be wrong. I don't know. I mean, you seem to have, you helped me, Esther.
Thank you so much. I'm glad to hear it. I love helping. I hope everyone pats themselves on the back today for something. Let's not be hard on ourselves. Let's work together and be strong.
Be positive. Work hard. Work smart. Put out good energy. Esther, stop crying. Is that Sprinkles or are you crying?
Sprinkles, come here.
Esther, can you cry on camera if you need to? You're actually tearing up a little bit.
Is Sprinkles a squirter?
You're disgusting.
Brian, that is uncalled for.
That's
you crossed
it.
The line.
You're done.
Stephen Brody Stevens. If you need to reach me, you can email me at brody@brodystevens.com, brody@brodystevens.com. I'm also on Twitter at brodyismefriend, brodyismefriend on Twitter. It's an homage to Tony and Mr. Lee, my busboys in New York. Brody, you good guy, you me friend.
Little Esther on Twitter, Esther Monster on Instagram.
And support this show, support Death Squad. Brian's doing a great job. He cares about the craft. I see him out there. He's not just some guy who lives in a computer room. He actually goes out and sees people and puts the time in, gains their trust, and reaches out. Esther and I, we weren't sure about this podcast today, but we ended up doing it. We did it at night here. A lot of times we do it in the afternoon, but Brian is has been there for us. Yes!
Does this song mean something different to you now?
Yeah.
You should really listen to the lyrics.
I like this.
One Night in Bangkok.
I never heard it before.
All right. You find me on Twitter. I'm Redband. Go to Brody Stevens' website and Esther's website. Buy their shit. Support them. Support their other podcast. And thanks for listening.
Festival of Friendship. Positive energy. Yes. One night in Bangkok. The world's your oyster. And all of a sudden.